Hopefully the chat works today. What's up, everybody? Today I'm working on the lighter. What's up, Arcane? How you doing, you guys? Today, this is a new item. The lighter is where you... I think you might actually even start the whole game with the lighter. I'm not sure. Or maybe you get the lighter like really quick. Because it's going to be used for puzzles. Like, you can light stuff on fire. And that could be perhaps some kind of switch and used in a puzzle. Or and also, the fires are going to be able to light each other, too. So if there's like 5 different unlit pillars, like this is an unlit pillar right here. If there's like 5 of them in a row, if you light the first one, it successively lights the next one and the next one and the next one. So there could be some really cool, intricate puzzles actually in the game based on that, just based on the lighter item. So, and then later on in the game, you get like, you can craft a flaming top hat, the flaming ghost sword, all that kind of stuff. That also will be able to light fire. So in after towards the middle of the game in the late game, you're probably not going to need the lighter anymore. But I think it will be really cool at the beginning of the game to be able to light things on fire. It won't be able to be used as a weapon though. It's just an actual lighter. Yeah. Does the lighter have a name? I think it's just going to be called the lighter. But if you want to shout out some names, let's see if we can come up with a better name than lighter. You reworked the pause menu. Right on. Cool, T. Nice. Okay, so yeah, let's get into making this. I got the code started. Oh, wait. That's going to do a screenshot thingy. Let's do that. Flamey thing? Flamey thing. Yeah, okay, so I got this area all set up. We can light stuff on fire. I need to work on the actual box for it. It's pretty big. I need to do an animations too. There'll be a custom animation. Right now I'm just using the drop animation. So I need to do a better animation. Dial in the hitboxes. Something else, but yeah, let's get started. Can you light slimes on fire? No, you won't be able to light enemies on fire. So that's why that's kind of reserved for crafting your top hat or your ghost sword. The lighter, I'm thinking, is not actually a weapon except for some enemies. So I'm thinking there will be actually most enemies in the game in general will not be able to be hit by the lighter, but there may be some kind of puzzle or something where you find out that the lighter can actually affect this one certain enemy or something like that. So, but anyways, in general, the lighter is just supposed to be the thing that lights pillars on fire and other things that can be lit on fire to basically, you know, work on puzzles and stuff for now. But I guess if it does, it could become a weapon at some point. Maybe it affects more than just a few, you know, rare enemies or whatever. I don't know. It's kind of cool to think about that kind of stuff because it makes the game world pretty interesting when you have an item that has multiple uses. And I learned that from watching the Sequelitis Zelda video. I'm like, oh my god, yeah. That's why Legend of Zelda 3, or what was that called? Link to the Past. That's why Link to the Past was so interesting, because a lot of your items could be used in multiple ways. Whereas in the future Zeldas, or the recent Zeldas or whatever, their items are more just one use. You know what I mean? This item always does that and only does that. It takes away a lot of the mystery from the game. Anyways, rants over. Industrial oil-powered flame creator? That's an IOPFK. IOPFK. Okay, first thing I'm going to do is work on this graphic. Flame under caution creation. Nice one. Nice one. You almost got me. Almost, man. Rocket Bunny. What's up, Rocket Bunny? Color of the world. So I like this existing drawing here, but actually, I don't like this existing drawing just yet. Let's work on this. Do. I wanna tell you about a girl though. Do. That. See how that's looking. Sheets. HUD. User slices only! User slices only! Industrial flame setter. Multiple tiers of lighters. Only got so much more time. I wish I could make every single item multiple tiered, but and you know what? I wouldn't want to actually. You gotta have some things that are just one item. It's just, there's no other item you get here. This never gets upgraded. Keep things somewhat simple, Okay, yeah, that's looking better, but I don't like the bottom still. That inside looks really good. Maybe even the side edge looks good like that. Gosh, it's so crazy how things change a lot when you put it in the game. You see what it looks like there? These edges, I want to be way closer to this color. And this edge. Yeah, a little darker there. Maybe darker there. Yeah. Maybe a little glow too, actually. Maybe some glow would be sweet, actually. Yeah, if I do like a yellow. Right here. Yeah, ooh, that's kind of nice. It's kind of nice. Ooh, that was really good, actually. 1.5. All right, double that up. Double it up. One, two, three. Yeah, nice and bright like that. Maybe there could be a perfume item which could be combined with a lighter to create a flamethrower. Starting to look better. I do love the glow. What if this were not selected? Yeah, it's got a nice little glow. Cool. Merge this. Lighter glow. Lighter. Let's turn that off real quick because I want. This is like a little too drippy for me. This is drippy art. There, that's a little cleaner art. Ah, that's nice too. Like this, but there's something. Oh. Yeah. Messing with it too much. Okay. Or maybe, oh, should it be a little lighter actually? Should the lighter be lighter? I just said that out loud, didn't I? Can the lighter be any lighter, please? From now on, I work at my mom's office every Friday. Wow. What are you doing there? Ludum Dare, number 35. Oh, you forgot your password? Can't you just do the password reset? Don't they have that? Oh yeah, that looks cleaner, nicer. Yeah, good job. Woo, yay! Good job. Good job. Maybe the bottom. Thinking that color right there, and this maybe there. Oh, no, stop. No, it's too much. Too much niceness. There's got to be a little bit of roughness. Oh, and I did want to see the overall color too. It might be too a little bit too dark. Sort of like a vintage Zippo. Actually, I like it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, more items need to look kind of like this. Yeah, that's pretty good. It's good enough for now. Okay, next up, I want to do the animations. For, oh, let me check this in actually. Git status. Oh, that's just all graphics. All right, now I got some animations for drop that I'm just using already. So I'll start with drop east. Oh, I should probably fix up drop sheath. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, I gotta put the player at the overworld. Oh, give the player the sword. Whoops. So sword. Thank you, Android. Thanks a lot. This email's already registered. What? Dang, I'm sorry, bunny. So what would be cool too is also be able to light it with, once you like, I would be able to use the lighter here. Just let him sheath the sword here. Right, if I could use the lighter here to light that pillar on fire, that'd be cool too. Lots of little things to do. Okay, so anyways, I want to check all these animations for using the lighter, so or the drop animation. Yeah. Okay, that's okay. Yep. Let's do east. Oh, okay, east. He's going back a pixel. Gotta fix that. North. North's pretty good. You can tell he's doing something. He doesn't flip his Z or anything, or his Y. Great. So I just need to fix that one drop sheath east. That should be like off by 1 pixel. Yeah. 1 pixel. That's all we need there. This is, put it in. Heroes, rock drop sheath east 0. Saved. I want to take off this stupid propagate frame one. Propagate frame one, worst feature ever. Okay, good. Now that animation should be fixed, and we'll be ready to do the lighter animations. Hurrah! Run. Run, run, run away. Run away, compiler. Oh, wow, the lighter looks purple. Whoops, wrong item. Oh, I noticed that instead. Whoa. Whoa. I had a Z issue there. North still looks good. East looks better, except that he's. Looks really funny with his chest moving that fast like that. Oh, it looks ridiculous. Oh my gosh. So what's he doing here? That should be like that. If anything, he might need to look a little bit like this. What? Did you email them? Did you try emailing their support to get their help with your password getting reset? I'm sure they can help you out. Let them dare. There we go. It's pretty good. Great, great, great. Okay, so I can check that in. Oh, first I'm gonna save these as some new files. All these. Well, no, I know I saved all these. Yeah, okay, we're good. This is fixed. Drop East sheet. Okay, yeah, so all these are going to get renamed to lighter rock, lighter East. Lighter south. Sheath. And I get all these exported too. Should have just done this as I was exporting them all. Man, I really wish I had an assistant artist. That would be so great. I'm not gonna be able to do that for this project, but maybe a future project. I would love to be able to draw like animations and have somebody fill in a whole bunch of like, the middle animations, the things that take so much time to create. You create 5 frames or whatever for an animation, it looks pretty good, but then it could look even better with 10 frames. But really, all it is just kind of blending 2 frames together, making sure it looks good. Get status. Good, good. We got all these new lighter effects and stuff. Let's get that getting built and the rocks. All these. Change to lighter. And we're also going to need some sword ones too. We'll just call all those sheath for now. Okay, that should be all what we need. So now I should still be able to go in there and use the lighter, and it should have exactly the same animation, but it's all set up so I can draw a new one, basically. What's up, Spud Gunnus? Android, well, why I don't know if there it would be that much benefit for me right now to switch animation programs. What happens when you try and, when you switch a program, it takes you months to get used to a new program and to get to the same level of efficiency that you were at least for me. For me, I'm talking personally here. Like for me, it takes me months to get used to a new piece of software. I'm trying to release this game here. I really do not have time to go switching any of my software at all. Maybe in a future project, yeah. Okay, so we should still be able to use a lighter. Oh yeah. Okay, cool. We got all the same animations. And if I put the player in the alternate dungeon, yeah. So, anyways, Android, thanks for your suggestion there. I'm sure, like in a few, maybe I'll do that as I get to the next project or whatever after Songbringer. We'll see. Okay, good. All right, all the animations are set up. Now I just want to start drawing. Okay. Wait, oh, let's get this checked in. Add all the PSDs, all the pings. Okay. Step one done. Step one, put your dick in the box. Step two, open the box. Step three. Wait, I think I skipped a step. Okay. All right, so we just need a little animation where he's got a lighter in his hand. It's lighting up his hand and stuff. I'm thinking his hand comes up to about there. Let's call it like that. That's fine. Let's get the color of the lighter. Right there. It's really dark. Oh, and I can't have that glow on. Did I get that color or that color? Don't know. Yeah, Andrew, I'm doing art right now. Yeah, Spud. Grab two of these colors while I'm here. Thank you very much. I love it. I love it. Okay, now it just needs a little glow. Nice. I was gonna mess that up, but I think I kind of like it like that. Bright. I don't know. See what that looks like in the game with that bright. It might be too bright. That's it. Cut a hole in the. Oh, first step is cut a hole in the box. Oh, that's right. Step one, cut a hole in the box. Yes. Spud gun is awesome. I'm so glad you found that useful. What you want to name, Zilton? What you want to name? Name anything. You want to name one of these skeletons? Here. What's this guy's name? He fell over. I don't think he likes me. Maybe this guy over here. He fell over too. They both want to be named though, I can tell. Oh, that's pretty cool. But I think if the player did this animation in 3 frames, it'd be a lot better. Okay, so let's do frame 1, frame 2, frame 3. Frame 1. This is like frame 3, 2, basically. Zero. If you're starting from 0, that's 2. So we get frame 2, 1, 0. Okay, so starting at frame 0. We got the art and everything separated. Frame 0, his hand comes to like boop boop halfway. This one, I'm thinking he actually has his hand out a little farther. The right one's Bob. Nip, 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 nip. Yeah. Okay, there, that one's done. And seeing how. Oh, yeah, let's do this. Okay, so that was 2 whoops. I think that was all. Okay, yeah, in this frame, it's gonna be looking like this. It goes 1, 2, 3. Oops. Okay, so the last bit I messed up because there the glow needs to be adjusted now. Adjust the glow. It's better. And maybe a little more glow there. Oh yeah. That's pretty good. Maybe not that last bit. Maybe not that. But yeah, that. Ah, that's pretty good. Okay. Let's render that. Heroes. Frame rate 10. Everything's 0.1 seconds. We're good to go. Render it. See, oh, and actually this needs to be Lighter East, which is this one, we're gonna go at like, I think 0.05, maybe 0.1. Has to repack the texture all the time, and the texture is huge at this point. There's so many sprites, and they're all so tiny they can all fit in it. Oh, that's awesome. Oh yeah. Okay, his hat, the glow on his hat, the shine. When he changes to that layer right there, this shine needs to adjust. And actually, I think that this head looking this way the whole time. Maybe not. Yeah, I'll try that first. Pixel art with big pixels is a whole different art than pixel art with smaller pixels, like. For example, if you're going with a 16-bit era game, your resolution and stuff can sometimes be 640 by 480-ish. 480p basically, max. And with this kind of pixel art, this is more of the 8-bit style pixel art, which is 240 max, right? Maybe 300 pixels maximum you're getting out of the height of your game. So all the pixels are bigger, blockier, and so it makes generating the art sometimes more difficult, but also sometimes just a little more simple. It's kind of beautiful that way. I've really enjoyed making a game with 8-bit style pixel art. That's awesome! Okay, the hitbox is definitely not awesome, but. Yeah, I love this lighter. Okay, now it's time to do the next frames. That's really good. I love it. Wait, can I move while doing it? Oh yeah, it doesn't stop. It needs to stop the player. We have to do this input lock too. Okay, so clearing the direction, setting the animation lighter, and then making sure it can't be overridden and you can't move while you're doing the lighter animation, but no worries, it's only 0.2 seconds. I'm in the UK and subscribe to a magazine called Retro Gamer. Yeah, Retro Gamer. Yeah, the 16-bit art skill, totally, right? Yeah, the 16-bit art skill is yeah, what I was trying to say there though is the 8-bit skill and the 16-bit skill are totally different. But yeah, the 16-bit one is also like its own form of art, you know? I'm loving this. I love this animation. Oh, and if I, yeah, that's, I'm running. I press that lighter button. It stops me. Good. Nice. That's cool. Okay, now let's finish the other two animations, north, south. And then we got to do all these animations times three. So there's that animation, there's one where your hat's off, there's another one where no, we're not going to do hat off. I guess we are going to have to do hat off. Yeah, there's four animations. There's hat off, there's with the sword, there's with your sheath. So there's three more sets of anime. That's nine more animations that have to be done, but anyways, they're all pretty easy. Lighter East. That's pretty good for a frame one, actually. Go there. Frame two. His hand moves like two, two. This is where his hand is at. Like right about there. Maybe like this pixel there. No. Yeah, that's. Hey. Yeah, that's pretty good. So he's got to have a lighter in his hand. Grab these pixel colors for the lighter. So he's got the lighter out, the next one. He's got the lighter lit. And this is where we get some glow too. Where are we gonna put the glow in this one? Maybe there. Okay, I'm gonna cheat and put it like here. Does that look wrong? It does. Looks totally wrong. We are gonna get light there. We can get it. Maybe some light there. That's really it. We can't get much more light on this one. The shading and they know how to do it, yeah. Yeah. It's yeah, the thing is though, it seems like a I know exactly how you feel, Spud, because that's where I was just a few years ago. I always thought that art was some, like you just said there, a mystical black art. I was like, I'm never gonna be able to do art. I never ever thought I would ever be able to do art. I thought I would always be a programmer. And then finally I started seeing that it's not a mystical black art, that anybody can do it, even total coders like I was. Okay, so yeah, we got this set up. Let's go back to frame one, frame two, frame three, and the light turns on. And this one, go back to that frame. This one looks funny. Just seeing it looped over and over. Okay, let's render that. Let's lighter north. Get it going. Whew, I am thirsty. I gotta get some more water. It's a hot day. It played with super slow delay. Forgot about that. All right, all of these delay 0.05. These are all going to be more involved arts. This is, it's like almost too fast. Is too fast. Maybe I'll go between 0.1 and 0.05. Yeah, you know what? This is a puzzly thing anyways. It shouldn't be that fast. Let's go back to 0.1 on all these. Let's try that. You're trying to take that step, but working on it. Nice, man. Yeah, totally. You know what? I feel like I'm starting to get good at it myself, but I still find it fascinating. And I'm still blown away by some artists. I'm like, oh my God, you just made that in front of my face or something? Like, what? How did you make that? I have a couple artist friends that are so good. It's so incredible the way they think about things. I don't even know. I can watch them paint for hours, you know? Like, I'll be enthralled watching my friend paint. All right, cool. That's better with the delay of point one. Okay, next animation, south. Frame zero. Frame one, the light. Oh, you know what? Those other animations haven't had the lighter yet in those first few frames. I wonder if what or in the few. I wonder what it looked like with that. Nice, man. The porcupine? Really? The porcupine, I remember that guy. I remember making that guy, I mean. Okay, he's just, this is good, but he's looking all the wrong way. Nah, he's now too many. He needs to be This is not 3D enough. Oh, I guess that does work. Yeah, that's okay. It's okay. It's okay. What's up, Azarus? Yes, he's got a lighter. Oh yeah, quick and seamless, right? Yeah, and the thing is, you're at this phase right now where you're not quite quick and seamless and everything like that, but you will become quick and seamless, and making art will become effortless for you at some point, you know? So keep that in mind. That's what you got to look forward to, is like being awesome at what you do already and also being awesome at making art, and it will empower you too. You'll be like, oh my God, I can do anything. I can do anything now. I can make my own games. All myself. Okay, let's throw this all together. Good, except for this hat again. I forgot about his hat. And his face, too. His face needs to move in this frame. His hat, too. This is where his hat moves. Cool, render. Exactly, Android. That's a cool way to say it. I've never heard that. I've never heard that saying before. The master has failed more times than the beginner has tried. So true. So true, man. You could say, God, that just says so much there. You know, I just want to tell everybody in the world that hasn't tried enough. That's all. That's all it is. Just trying more. Because you love it, you know? That's why I do it. That's why I fail so much, is I love to fail, I guess. I love to learn. I know that every experience that is what seems like a failure to some is actually a learning experience to others. I know that's a cheesy line, right? You hear that a million times, but it's true. I'm liking this. I'm liking this a lot. Okay, next, now that I've got this kind of like dialed in with the art, at least for this much of it done, there's a lot more to do. I've got to do without his hat. I have to do the version when the sword's out. I have to do another version where there's a sheath, where there's a sword on his back. So anyways, there's a lot more to do there, but I'm going to check this in and I'm going to work on the hitboxes next. So I'm going to like dial this in where exactly the hitboxes are, right? This needs to feel just right. So I'm gonna turn on draw debug permanently. So every time I start, it just always already has that on. Toggle to one and then check in what I got so far. Oh, since I'm gonna code here for a second, I'm gonna put away the graphics tablet and go back to the mouse. Oh, I forgot about those animations. What's up, good? Good, Paul? You gotta have something to stay sane, right? Totally. Sounds like you're a creator at heart, Spud. You got some creativity to share with the world. It'd be a shame for the world to not experience the creativity that you have to offer. Think about that. Lighter thief. I said lighter thief. I was thinking about lighter thief because of the lighter. Lighter thief. What's up, buddy? So obviously the hitbox is way too big, and the unlit pillars hitbox. Oh, whoa, see, look at this. This is one thing I would never want to open. And it's lock.h. Nope, nope, I want areacreation.cpp. My project. Why would I want to open up the system libraries? Cache it, yo. So, yeah, I explained this at the beginning of the stream, but it's been a while since then, so let me explain what's the plan with the lighter. The lighter is going to be a cool way to experience puzzles. So puzzles are what's on my mind right now. And this entire dungeon here, this is going to be a puzzle dungeon. The focus is not on combat. You don't even have the sword. There's no jib. Jib is stuck on the outside because this is a psychedelic trip. You're experiencing a crazy trip at this point. This is not even going to look like this. There's not going to be... No, I'm showing you stuff that's not even going to be there. But basically, the point of this dungeon is to solve some puzzles. And you learn the meditation skill. Check it out. You can meditate now. Pretty cool, right? And the meditation skill is going to be used with puzzles as well, but it's also going to be central to the gameplay. It's going to be central to beating the game. You'll see. And I don't want to ruin too much by talking about what meditation does and doesn't, because it's going to be a sweet skill. So you got meditation. And then the lighter. The lighter is going to be used for puzzles. So the way that the lights are going to work from now on is that if there's two pillars right next to each other, so let's say these two pillars here, this pillar and that pillar were right next to each other, and I lit this one on fire, after like half a second, it would light the next one on fire. So that way there could be some sweet ass puzzles, like maybe there's a row of them or something like that that lead up to something else, and you have to do some timing puzzle or something like that to light the fire at just the right time on a screen or something. I don't know. But there's just any way to get some simple puzzles to solve, to make the game a lot more interesting, because right now the game is very, very heavily combat focused, and that's cool. And as long as you're nailing the way the combat's working in your game, I think that's gonna work for you. But like, and I think it works pretty well in Songbringer. I love the top hat, I love the sword, I love the bombs and everything, the ghost sword and all that. But still, if the game has awesome combat and it has some decent puzzles, you know, that's going to be better. It's going to be more variety as a player. There's going to be, and I'm appreciating that playing Hyperlight Drifter. Hyperlight Drifter has some great little puzzles. They're not extensive or huge or anything. They're mostly contained to like one screen, but they do the job, right? It's nice to have a time to be combative and to fight and to be a hero and all that in that sense. But it's also nice to solve puzzles and be a hero as well. You're a frustrated creative type? Music's your outlet? Nice. You call yourself old. I'm the same way, man. I'm 36. Oh, DM John, yeah, HLD is incredibly hard. I've rage quit twice playing Hyperlight Drifter. Rage quit, man. I don't really consider myself much of a rage quitter, but that game drove me to rage quit. And then when I finally went back and actually beat this one boss, it was an empty beat. It was an empty win because I had to look it up on the internet. Yep, substance of the game, combat, art. Oh, we're the same age. Right on. We're the same age, brothers. What's up? Oh, you know what? These fire pillar things, these were created back in a day where I didn't even have Z, so I used Y instead. So simple solution here. This is just P.Y, P.X, and then 20 above it. And now we'll create a block that can be hit, but the position will be just right. Okay, so now if I run it, the unlit pillars should be right next to the pillar. You wouldn't even be able to tell the difference. That too, cash it, yeah. But you know what? I don't know why people are crying so much about the 30 frames a second on Hyperlight Drifter. I can't even, I know I can tell the difference between 30 and 60, but I still think the game plays amazing, and the frame rate really doesn't affect my art sense. You know, like the art in Hyper Light Drifter is so phenomenal. I don't think I've ever seen such incredible artwork in any video game I've ever played. I mean, Sword and Sorcery, that was one where I really appreciated the art. I thought it was freaking awesome, but Hyper Light Drifter takes it all to another level. So amazing. What's up, Zynger? It's not even working at all. Did I put it too low? Maybe it's hitting both of them at once. That can't be. What happened? Oh, it could be the Z. I put the Z at 20, but the lighter itself might be a Z of 20. Oh, that's probably it, huh? Yeah. So, enemy text. Lighter. This thing needs to be taller. Let's try that. 40 pixels tall. What's my thoughts on age and game programming? 30s old? No way, man. Are you kidding me? 30s old? No way. I don't believe that for a second. No way. Don't believe the internet, man. The internet's not right about you and your personal situation, or me and my personal situation. No one can tell you what is old except for yourself. So whatever you choose is old, that's old. Everything else doesn't matter. Why did that thing get lit on fire like that much though? Because the unlit pillar thing is what gets lit. Where is that part where it actually gets lit? Oh yeah, here it's in health system. This is where it lights a fire pillar. And it creates fire right at the position. What is this? Create fire. Vec2? Give me a break. Vec2? Vec2? Come on, man. We need three components to every vector. Sheesh. Base pause. Light offset. That's better. Get that compiling. Base pause plus light offset. There we go. Now it's not going to ignore that awesome Z number I just gave it. I agree, DM John. 30s when programmers are usually just coming into their own. Totally. I feel like I'm finally coming into my own. I'm 36 now. I feel like I can do every skill that I've always dreamed of doing. I feel like I'm doing exactly what I want to do. I feel like I'm doing what I was meant to do, what I was born to do. So, I don't know. I almost feel like it would suck to be any younger. Have I implemented vanilla Entity Foo Entity Component System or more advanced ECS version? No, it's vanilla Entity Foo. I haven't changed a single thing. Look at this. Entity foo, I'm gonna go straight to entityfoo.h in this project. It's exactly what you see on GitHub. This is exactly what I've published on GitHub. Entityfoo.h. I use exactly that and I just extend it. I extend off of these components. All I do for Songbringer is I create all my own components and create all my own systems. But I use exactly this file. See if that fixed that bug. Your opinion is age is just a number, right? It's true. Oh, don't believe that stuff about if you're not a manager by a certain age. Once again, that's to generalize a person's own worth It's so unfair. You can't generalize a person's worth like that. You know, a manager by your age, you've failed in life. No way, dude. I don't believe that for a second. Oh, and you give two fingers that notion. Nice. All right. Interesting to hear a sane person's opinion. Yes. Yes, stop listening to the insane people on the internet that are spreading lies. Hey, it did work. It lit the pillar on top with the Z at the right point. Oh, what's that though? Oh, there's two entities. There's one entity. I think it's doing. Anyways, I'm gonna dial in the hitbox for the lighter a little bit. I think it should be a little less, a little skinnier. Size horizontal or ver yeah, horizontal, skinnier. So maybe 15 horizontal. Maybe like 30 tall, like 25 tall. Yeah, DM John. Lesson for today: don't listen to the internet. Okay, I'm just dialing in these hitboxes here. I'm thinking that's looking better with this slightly less tall, slightly less wide, horizontally. Yeah, real loft, very good way to put it too. Most people that say you're a failure are the ones that failed in their life. So true. And the reason why? They don't want to admit that they failed in their life. So they think that it's somebody else's failure. Or it's something they've been told their whole life, right? Maybe their pop or their pa or their ma or somebody told them their whole life that you're a failure by this age if you don't do something in your life or whatever. And I would say that's not even like a mom pop thing. That's more like a general society thing. If you don't, just whatever, don't buy into what general society has to say for you, because once again, you're a completely unique individual. Completely unique. There's no one else in the entire universe exactly like you. That's good. Okay, that's it. Yeah, it's a little too much on the. See, I didn't. I wanted to, like, yeah, it's too wide. You need to be really close to use the lighter. Let's go down another five. Maybe more like eight. Right? Okay, so that's pretty. Yeah, pretty dialed in now. Pretty close. That's pretty good. Yeah, I like that. Yeah, that's good. Cool. 8 by 25 it is. All right, let's dial in the vertical height now. This is probably too wide. Let's do like 15, 25. Start. Thank God there's no one like me. The world would suck. Yeah, it might be too tall still. I think it is actually. That's way too tall. This could be like 15 maybe. On average, how many hours a day do you work on Songbringer? Well, I've been working 7 days a week on Songbringer. Most days I get 10 hours in. I'd say it's about an average. And on weekends, I'll do something in the morning or something in the afternoon, and so I won't work like 10 hours on weekends or whatever, more like 8. But I think it kind of averages out. There's been periods where, like during the Kickstarter phase, I was 12 hours a day at least, with all the extra communication and marketing you have to do during a Kickstarter. But yeah, I work a lot, man. I actually work too much. I'm pretty much skimming just above burnt out all the time. And so I probably need to take more time off. I really should take one day a week at least, and completely take the day off and just do fun stuff more in life, and not, smell the roses while I'm making this game. Enjoy making this game even more. I'm really kind of pressured right now because I really got to get this game done. Backers expected this project in December of last year. Now it's already been 4 or 5 months beyond that. I gotta get the game out this year. I gotta get it done. So I feel a lot of pressure in that regard. That's why I work so much. But it's getting there, slowly but surely. It's as a one man band, I can only do so much, and so I gotta be happy with whatever I do get accomplished. I think this is looking pretty good. Let's see what it feels like. I'll turn off the hitboxes now, and we'll start with going to north. Nice. You had to get pretty close to that, though. Let's try going from the south now. I know, Android, right? I am amazed too. I guess I probably can work so long and so much because I guess I do yoga. That helps. Whoa, look at the player. When he's moving, he's like a pixel wider. Oh, because he's half aligned and he's half not. That's so crazy. Oh, that's crazy. I really want to see that fixed. It's because of the frame buffer. And him being half a pixel too much in one direction, it makes his face a little wider. Huh, so vertically, I felt it was almost too tall, and then north was too tall, south was a little too short, but I think they're pretty good. Pretty good for dialing like that. Let's try it now without the debug masks on. It does. The project means a lot to me. I do. It does mean a lot to me. Songbringer is, I really feel, is the first thing in my entire life that I've created that I'm actually proud of. And that's really crazy to say, but like, all the other games I've made, I didn't make the art. I didn't really, I didn't do all of it. And so sometimes, like whatever, if I, or maybe if I worked on a team, whatever. The point is, this creation is all my own, and I feel really fulfilled by that. It's like a very fulfilling project to be doing this and to kind of feel like it's working. Like this game, feel like it's working. It's fun for me to play it at least. And I know other people out there are having a good time playing it too, so it is very, very rewarding. Okay, one more time. Thanks, Android. Cool. Yeah, I'm liking this. I'm liking the way this is all dialed in. Cool. Okay, so the next thing, I want to be able to get this all dialed in and all that and perfected and all that, but I think the next thing I'm going to do is make them so they can light each other up. So if there's a bunch of them in a row, they will light each other one after another. So I'm going to check in what I just did there. Does it feel like work and you get lost for hours without realizing? My own projects feel like that, but they are outside the day job. No, it does not feel like work at all to be doing that. That's probably another reason why I can work 7 days a week or whatever. It's not really work. I'm doing exactly what I want to do. I love making this. So It's just easy to spend a lot of time at it and not even realize that you spend a lot of time at it. Okay, so to get them to light up each other, there's area patterns, pattern level entrance. It pushes back a whole bunch of, where does it put the pillars? Oh, here it is, lights, unlit pillar. Okay, so on the left side, I'm gonna put like three, four of them in a row. Cool, we got four in a row. Let's see what happens if I do one. Oh, the hitbox was big enough to get two of them at once there. Okay, cool. So what I want to see happen here is I want to light the top one and have each one light in succession. You can see it's hitting the pillar there. I don't want it to actually hit the pillar. I want it to just light the pillar, but I'll fix that later. So let's get this to, so when it lights a fire, I'm thinking that it, when that fire actually ignites, half a second later, the fire checks around it to see if there's anything, if there's any other entities that could be lit by the fire, and then it will. Okay, chain lighting. I'm trying to think of the simplest way to do this so they can all this one entity triggers another entity and keep the system simple. I guess the first thing to do would be to abstract this function where it lights a fire pillar here, but it'd probably be just best to make this a function somewhere so it's just, easier to call. And then it returns true or false whether it did create a lighted fire pillar. And then it's pretty easy to just go. If that succeeds, or if it doesn't succeed, create a damaging fire entity. So where would the appropriate place be for lighting a fire pillar? Also, it needs to do this when it creates a pillar, an unlit pillar, like a, yeah, an unlit pillar. When it creates an unlit pillar, it needs to check and see if it's already been lit before. And if so, it also needs to create this at area creation time. So probably the best place to put this is area. Area create fire. Yeah. If the pillar is lit, just man, maybe even activate 0 HP. Yeah. Activate 0 HP might be the best place to put this. Man, I don't know. I don't know which way to do this right now. Okay. I'm gonna do something else. But anyways, I'll leave this for later. But my goal here, like I was just saying, is I want one fire pillar to light another. And I'm trying to do it a simple way. I'm probably overthinking it at this point. So usually what happens when I start overthinking is I just start working on something else, and that usually that helps me to forget. Isn't it lighting that bottom one? Oh, it might have tried to light the other ones. Okay, so yeah, I'm gonna do some art for a minute till we're done with the stream. Actually, man, I'm tired already. How many hours have I been streaming? Only an hour and a half? I could do a couple animations. Couple animations here. Let's do the sheath one. Oh, the sheath one is so easy if I just take the other ones already. No, I just need to make sure that's lining up with the idle. Oh, yeah, it's right there. North. Is it to the right or to the left? Oh, I always forget. It's flipped that way and it's on the right. Last one. Okay, let's see if all that worked. I'll put the player back at the overworld. And I have the sword, so it should be sheath mode. Why is that, DM John? Oh, because of Ludum Dare. That's right, I forgot about that. I'm stoked for everybody that's doing one this time. Looks good. I want to see though, I want to see some, want to see the little sparks and flames that come out of it look, actually line up with where it is though. It's not too hard, I don't think. If I go to input system, instead of using the lighter, I can use the lighter.attack.collision EID. Oh, both those need render components. That won't work. Well, I can at least make, is it fire particles or is it fire trail that I'm thinking about here? Fire trail. This thing does these little explosions and it puts them kind of random. DRNF times 8. That's way too much. Put that to 2. It works, but it's putting them way closer to the middle, so that's why it's not working for this entity. So we need like a different entity. It's, I guess, the fire entity itself. I guess the fire entity itself could move, but I don't have to redial in everything. I think it is better with those lower. Let's keep that there. Fire particles, fire. Wait, what does fire particles do? It does something else, but I guess it does kind of look cool. But anyways, we'll get a vector from compass direction that we're attacking in, and we'll add a little bit to the position of the lighter entity. Might as well try this, is what I'm thinking. So yes, Jib is meant to be like R2-D2, right? He's totally the inspiration for Jib, R2-D2. But now we got the BB-8. BB-8's kind of cool, too. He grew on me. It kind of works. I think I'm gonna make it so V dot Y is greater than 0. Equals 0. And then to the sides, I'm thinking. B dot X is 6, B dot Y, 4. So what I'm doing here is I'm moving the entity that the fire is spawned from, so that when you see those little tiny fire particles, they look like they come out of the lighter now, instead of just coming out of random places or near in Rock's hand or whatever. Pretty good, but I'm thinking 7. 7 or 8. Maybe 8. Facing south, they don't ever have the right Z, though. Okay, I'm gonna make this the Z variable. I'm grabbing the render systems, what it would use for a Z, or I mean component. For KZ mid this time, instead of low, I'm going with mid. An offset of maybe 0.1 instead of negative 997. So that should put the Z of the fire at the appropriate point instead of underneath everything. The theme is shapeshift. Interesting. I love how it has a theme always. They have some pretty cool themes too. There we go. I'm thinking now that if your v dot x is 0 and your v dot y is less than 0, your v dot x is equal to e.render.sprite dot is flipped x so we're talking like shifting it by 4 pixels if you're facing directly south. Nice, it's working. Like, and no matter which way I turn, it's looking like it's coming right out. Oh, except for north. Okay, so north does need to be like something. Ooh, still needs more, damn. I need to turn that off, actually. It's not working. Oh, I'm adding one, aren't I? Damn, same thing. Maybe negative one. Dang, this is proving difficult. Negative four, would that work? No, what? Jump height. I don't think I'm using jump height. Maybe I am using jump height. Salt. What? Oh my God. Maybe it needs to be plus 20. Man. Keeps putting fire up there. What's up? Why? Of course. I just did Z order mid. This needs to be Z order based on the position. Here we can do an offset of zero, maybe, and position is where it starts. Ground position. Nice. Oh. Perfect Z positions. Right on. Now if I just dial in the positions again this way, I think it just needs to be less wide, slightly. It's gonna be in raw. No. In the text. Lighter. Size H is going to be even shorter. Four, maybe. Wow, it's short. And then three. I think I can live with that. Okay, that's good too. It'd be cool if you could light this guy on fire. What about coming at it from below? That was too close. Needs to be not so tall. How about we do actually go negative two? If it's north, make it south. Oh, I could mess up the Z. The Z order. Yeah, it did. Okay, we'll do that and we'll. Make it not as tall, I guess. Just go 10. Oh, boo. Oh my god, a new version of Amber's Boots available! You gotta update right now! Negative two. Nice. Works once again, and we got a shorter height. Let's check this out. Yeah, that's still good. I like it. Let's try it from below. That was still too far away, but it's passable at this point. Same thing there, maybe a little too. Yeah, that's all I'm gonna tweak it today. All right, everybody, so that's it for today's stream. I got the lighter started. My next goals tonight are to work on this system so that I can light one on fire and it lights the next one on fire and the next one, and the next one. It just goes in a chain. It can light a fire chain, like a daisy chain of fire. And then the next goal is to get that working with puzzles. So the goal is to create a puzzle system. So one of these pillars maybe will be like the switch pillar. And once you light the switch pillar on fire, why isn't it light that one? I guess I gotta keep working on this, because what's up? What's up with this? That works. But yeah, you guys get the point, right? Puzzles, that's the point. So yeah, we'll see you guys next time. Have a good time, and thanks for watching.